Alex Jones here with urgent information concerning TrendsResearch.com. The Trends Journal distills the voluminous ongoing research of the Trends Research Institute into a concise, readily accessible form. By tracking 300 separately defined domestic and international trends, the Trends Journal establishes the connections that others fail to see or misinterpret. Gerald Salente's Trends Journal allows you to anticipate change, recognize the implications, and take protective strategies. Individual readers from every walk of life can put the Trends Journal Trends Forecast and Trends Analysis to practical use. Extra information to keep you well informed throughout the year. When any current event of major social, economic, or political significance occurs, Trends Journal notifies its subscribers of their implications. When you subscribe to the Trends Journal, you'll also receive Trends Alerts. Visit TrendsResearch.com today. That's TrendsResearch.com. Subscribe to the Trends Journal. This information is too important to wait.
You may be arrested and or subject to other police action.
Tyranny is here. The grim future foretold in 1984 has become reality.
It really says that the state is God.
The United States is now recognized globally as one of the most oppressive police states on Earth. This film conclusively proves the existence of a secret network of FEMA camps, now being expanded nationwide. This documentary exposes how the continuity of government program has established an all-powerful shadow state. Police State 4 chronicles the sickening depths to which our republic has fallen. Prepare to enter the secretive world of emergency dictatorship. Body scanners, sound cameras, citizen spies, stage terror, and cameras on every street corner. It's only the beginning of the New World Order's hellish plan. The police state isn't coming. It's here. Secure your copy today at Infowars.com or see it online in the highest quality at PrisonPlanet.tv. Hi, folks. This is Alex Jones asking you for a minute of your time to tell you about soap. Not detergents, but good old-fashioned pure soap made by the Calbin Soap Company, a family-owned and operated American company. My family, staff, friends, and radio listeners are constantly telling me how much they love these products for bath, hair, laundry, and dishes. There is nothing like these factory-direct, big-money-saving, triple-concentrated soaps anywhere. Get a free detailed catalog by calling 800-340-7091 or see them online at 5starsoap.com or Infowars.com. Let's talk to the owner of 5 Star Soap, Marty Schachter, and see what he has to say.
As founder and owner for over 63 years, people keep asking me, how's business? I'm happy to say our business is going down the drain. Call us at 1-800-340-7091. Visit our website, 5starsoap.com, for buying a 1 to 2 month soap sampler. Thank you.
What we've got here is failure to communicate. Some men you just can't reach. So you can get what we had here last week, which is the way he wants it. Well, he gets. I don't like it any more than you do.
Waging war on corruption. It's Alex Jones.
Look at your young men fight.
I'm going to have Rob Du pop in, tell you what he saw at the G20, just to remind folks. And it turns out this Israeli intelligence-connected company was involved spying on the citizens. And not just with the G20, and being paid by the state to compile a list of people they said posed a terrorist threat. Now, the governor is apologizing for this. They want to keep all this secret. But remember NLE 09 and NLE 010 this year with FEMA. In the FEMA press releases, it said troops from 14 countries training to take on the American people. Then I sent Rob Du and Jason Douglas a few months ago to Chicago. And they had multiple drills of putting Americans in the sports stadium and putting up barbed wire. They had multiple drills with Polish and other troops practicing to take on the American people. They admit in the Washington Post that they've got a North American Union SPP deal to use, quote, Mexican and Canadian troops in the U.S. At the G20 this year, they used U.S. forces the cities where they had the G20 meeting. This is being done everywhere. And they had black and blue vans pulling up with people in shorts and T-shirts, grabbing citizens and throwing them in vans and putting bags over their heads. Same thing at the G20 a year and a half ago in England. The same thing is being done everywhere. And they do it in front of news cameras. And we put out National Guard snatches and grabs people with that video from the G20. And we got contacted that day by G20 private security at this office. I called the number back. It was the official G20 command center number. And they said, we're not going to tell you our names, but you can see our number and caller ID. Those were private security forces who wear U.S. Army National Guard uniforms. So, I mean, that's classic third world. You ever seen Romancing the Stone? Great movie with Douglas in it, where the bad guy is all over the Latin American countries, and one time he's a general, next he's a colonel, then he's a police chief. He's always wearing, what's his name, Zorro or something in it. The point is, that's really what a secret police is like. They do whatever they want. You don't know who they are. They've got fake IDs. They're foreign, and they're just running around doing whatever they want. So this report is so big. Remember back in the 1990s, in fact, I think it was 1994. Will you guys search engine Mossad caught in San Francisco breaking into police files, and they actually got convicted for it? It was Mossad acting as ADL. Headline, ADL caught breaking into police files. And it turned out they were paying off police and basically running the police department intelligence unit. And so this is real, ladies and gentlemen. And I talked about this yesterday and saw the YouTube video, people commenting, I can't believe Alex is criticizing Israel. He never does that. We've done hundreds of videos criticizing when Israel does things like this. People every time say, this is the first time I've ever seen it. I've never seen it. Look, we criticize anybody who is in here violating the Bill of Rights and Constitution. And imagine, again, if the Chinese were doing this, if our government had hired the Chinese to come in and spy on Americans and to be involved, the evidence is beginning to show, in the snatching and grabbing. And Luke talked about seeing the trucks and vans come in, people with bags on their heads. They would take people and strip them down and then make fun of them and laugh at them. Rob Dew saw this go on. Rob Dew just tried to go to the military and say, I'd like to talk to your spokesperson. And then they called the police and said they were trying to blow up the base. I mean, this just out of hand. You're an American scumbag media. You come to the U.S. Army and politely say, it's all on video in the film. We have the footage shot from the car, very politely saying, yes, sir, we'd like to. We saw your press release. We said the media should make inquiries here at the base to talk to the military. And they just came out and called the police and said, hey, these are terrorists. They were sneaking around, maybe trying to attack the base. Pulled right up to the front. This is what America is now. This is bona fide, hardcore tyranny. This is everything we supposedly fought the Soviets over and fought the Nazis over. And Israel's a police state. England's a police state. The United States is a hardcore police state. They're setting up checkpoints all over the country now, searching people. And the police are in NBC News saying, quote, we can do whatever we want. You don't have any rights. And then here's this article. Government bans Tea Party from celebrating U.S. Constitution. Today is Constitution Day. They tried to get a permit for 2 months in multiple towns. They already, at the beginning of the year, were denied the right to demonstrate. First, they trick you and say you've got to get a permit. Then they deny the permit. You don't need a permit to demonstrate, only if you're going to block roads for a parade, for a commercial parade. They're training you, you can't demonstrate. They're training you, you don't have rights. I noticed in Chicago, tens of thousands of police demonstrated yesterday, and I read the articles closely. They didn't get a permit, but the police didn't go after them. And I say that's good, because you don't need a stinking permit to go protest outside City Hall or the police station. I couldn't believe a few months ago in Austin, a local group went and got a permit to protest. You just give in to this evil when you do that. A permit? That's like a permit to own a gun. It's outrageous. I'm not criticizing people. I'm just sick of it. But look at this. Pennsylvania Homeland Security puts anti-tax protesters on list of terror threats. Pittsburgh Tribune Review. Lawsuits are now filed. But it was every group. It was peaceful groups. Remember Fahrenheit 9/11 showed groups in Houston and in Northern California who would bake cookies and sit around and talk about peace, and they had police informants inside their groups? Remember what came out back in November of 2008? It's in the Obama deception, that Ron Paul was being watched in Houston at his In the Fed rally, and then in Dallas, we were being watched, and it said in the Army report that was leaked to us by Patriots at Camp Mabry, by the way, it said in the report, don't let them know you're Army, they may kill you. You got a multiracial crowd out there saying, we don't want banker bailouts. We want the Federal Reserve audited. And because of that, and notice the year after that, the House passed the law. The Senate blocked it to audit the Fed. And the Army was there. The Army. Well, if you don't like the Army spying on you, how about Israeli operatives? How about Israeli operatives paid taxpayer money to spy on everybody? Did you guys find the ADL caught breaking into police intelligence files? It's everywhere. It's from the call Watson. He's the ultimate master of searches, even better than me. He'll be able to find it. I don't want to make a claim here and then not put it up on screen. We must put it up on screen. Let me think of the exact search headline. That's it. ADL caught stealing police intelligence files. I mean, that's it. ADL caught stealing police intelligence. No, I know you are. I'm just trying to get the answer to the thing so we can get that out there for people. Okay, let's go to Rob Dew about this. Rob, I mean, what do you think of the fact that you now learn that not only was the Army out there spying on people, but that the Israeli Mossad-connected private intelligence group?
After going to the G20, nothing surprises me anymore. I mean, these these people are out of control. They treated everybody that I saw there, you know, these were peaceful protesting citizens, and they were treated like common criminals. We were locked up, and I had actually, they told us to leave, and I started to walk up a hill where they were coming down the hill. They had scheduled this to be an entrapment exercise. They call it kettling. And so they rounded up a bunch of people. Most of them were college kids that weren't even protesting. They just happened to be on the campus, walking around in their boxer shorts and T-shirts. And anyway, halfway through the night, they start bringing in people. The one guy that I particularly saw, he was breathing heavy. He had the bag over his head, and then they had him hogtied with the handcuffs by, and they had four guys, one on each limb, carrying him in. And he seemed like, you know, he was maybe not hyperventilating, but breathing really heavy. He was very distressed. And they brought him into a room, set him in a chair, I guess. I don't know what they did, but they had a video camera on him the whole time and two guys sitting outside the room looking at him with the door open. And this guy couldn't have been more than, 95, 115 pounds. He wasn't that big at all. And you could tell the mindset with these guys that were watching us. They thought they were doing, God's work. And it was really distressing to see that, especially because people were listening to the police. When they said to move, they were trying to move, but then they had already blocked off the streets and kettled them in, and so there was nowhere to go.
No, they were trying to set a precedent
to not protest.
They were trying to set a precedent to scare everybody, so less and less people come out and protest. Yeah. The statistics show worldwide where these exact same tactics of the stormtrooper outfits, the hired provocateurs, so the police can attack the peaceful crowds. Yeah. This is being done by design. Guys, you can zoom in with the document cam video here on the screen. Spy case updated. Former policeman Tom Gerard returned to San Francisco from the Philippines May 7th and was immediately arrested on four counts of conspiracy, stealing government documents. The stolen records and police intelligence files were ordered destroyed in 1990 and contain information on thousands of individuals and hundreds of groups ranging across the political spectrum. Some 1,200 of the individuals listed on his files are Arab Americans who have never broken any laws. And it goes in to talk about the Anti-Defamation League basically hiring police officers and police departments all over California to give them these files. But now they don't even need to do that. Now they can just go and get paid by the government and be tied into Homeland Security. So you've got a foreign power who's been caught spying on the U.S. over and over again, now being paid to advise Homeland Security, now being paid to be inside Homeland Security and to spy on the American people.
Yeah, and if you go ask a question about it, they're going to send, sick the sheriff on you, which is what they did to us. We went up there. You could see it all on Police State 4. We laid it all out on the line. We drove up. It was me and Jason Burmis, asked to speak to the PAO. He finally comes out. We ask him a couple questions. He doesn't want to answer anything on camera, doesn't want to talk to us, doesn't like our credentials. Says it's the middle of the night when it was, 7:50 p.m., in the evening. It wasn't that late. We leave. A car follows us as we're leaving, gets off after an exit and does a turnaround. But they were waiting for us on the opposite side of the road, facing the opposite direction. They turn around and get behind us. And then we get back to the hotel.